This is NBA Jam from Midway in 1993. This is one of the first real basketball games that had digitized actors. And Midway, around this time, had released Mortal Kombat, you know, a year earlier, and they were on fire, so to speak. They had this and Mortal Kombat, and this is one of the two biggest games in 92-93. So much so that later on, Acclaim had actually picked up the home rights and became a monsterly big home manufacturer of console game cartridges for the SNES and also the Genesis because of this. So here you go. You got a team, and you pick, let's say, the Orlando Magic, you know, because they're the best team in the NBA. I'm not biased or anything, because I live in Orlando, but at this is the time you pick a couple of teams, and here we play in Orlando and Sacramento. If you take a look at the players, they're all digitized, so you can see their faces and everything. And this was really, really cool for that time. And here you've got Scott Skiles and Shaquille O'Neal. Now, what's interesting in the home versions, Shaquille O'Neal and other people were not in the home versions. And also, like, Michael Jordan was in the arcade one. And the reason is they had to pay a licensing fee. And so they didn't get in because it was too expensive. They decided to replace them with, you know, Penny Hardaway, whoever. So you go around the court, and there's really no referees, and you can do a lot of things that you couldn't really do in a normal game. It's a two-on-two game, so you can have, you know, four players here going around either by yourself, or you can have the computer playing for you. Here I'm playing a one-person game, and my teammate's computer versus two computers, and you go around and do all these things, and if you do three in a row, you get this on fire. So you get all these extra things, and you can do, like, these funky dunks and all these things you couldn't do in normal real life basketball that you could do here if you know how to actually make it do that, which is a really tough thing to do. Because with Mortal Kombat and also this, they had all these special things that you had to look in video game magazines for that very few people knew unless you actually knew it. So that was kind of a way to sell video game magazines, which is also a way to get the games in the video game magazines. Midway had released an 89 Arch Rivals and 90 High Impact and 91 Super High Impact, and this came out in 93, so they had a line of basketball games, and this was really based off of the Arch Rivals game. It's more of an updated version of it, but with digitized actors and real life digitized actors. For a time there, this was, you know, pretty cool kind of stuff, you know. Now there's actually a little code thing in there where if the designer didn't really like the Chicago Bulls, so when they're playing the Detroit Pistons and you try to get the point at the end of the game, there's a code thing that makes you miss. So if you're playing the Chicago Bulls, sometimes you not get the points. But there you go. That is NBA Jam by Midway.